in Connecticut, raised in Philadelphia, and now living on Cape Cod. But my mother's family was born in New Orleans, Louisiana, and the roots there in Louisiana have pulled at me. Today, they pull me even harder. It's 60 years since the father of American documentary, Robert J. Flaherty, made his landmark film, Louisiana Story, a film about a young boy whose bayou is transformed by the appearance of an oil rig. This film has always been discussed in my family. I recently found out why.
I don't know much.
My mother, Mary Goldman.
Mile Salt was a salt company that my grandfather owned. Mile Salt Company eventually got sold to the Morton Salt Company. The Benjamins kept the mineral rights. And then Shell Oil Company had found oil and drilled it, and the family got royalties from the oil. And my mother had a vial of black stuff on her dresser, which she said was black gold.
My grandmother knew Robert Flaherty. She had both sides of the coin. She was suddenly rich by oil, but enormously sympathetic to Flaherty. While he was there, they were best friends. She found him his locations. She was his fixer and his guide. Flaherty got to make his great film. Standard Oil of New Jersey got to resuscitate its image and got its PR. But Louisiana ultimately got wrecked.
Let me out. Set me free.
So I set out to check on the Louisiana story, 60 years on. I even found the boy who had been so moving in the film. Now 75 years old, J.C. Boudreaux.
Set me free.
It hurt. It hurt the marshes, hurt the wildlife. You know, I'm brought up where they had meadowlarks all over. And I hadn't seen any for about 20 years. And here about 5 years ago, I seen two of them. That was such a beautiful sight. Water come out of my eyes, tears, just to see a meadowlark.
So I go to Weeks Island, Louisiana, the place of my great-grandfather's Miles Salt Mine. It's about 2.5 hours west of New Orleans, but it's next to the bayou. And it's here that I meet Wilma Subra, an award-winning chemist, activist, and grandmother who wants to make the world a better place for her grandchildren. It's here that she fights for environmental justice against one of the proposed new uses of this former strategic petroleum reserve.
This company wants to put oil field waste into this cavern. They want to receive it on the intercoastal at a docking facility. They want to slurry it, and then they want to inject it down into this storage cavern. And in the long term, you'll have all of this waste that may migrate to the surface or contaminate groundwater in the area, and you'll have no control over that.
My cousin, Edward Benjamin.
But when you carry it to its logical conclusion, it would be saying, let's go back to where it was originally, which you can't do and which you don't want to do.
I set out to trace Flaherty's steps in an effort to understand the contradictions. My family fortune versus an environmental legacy. Was Louisiana really wrecked? And who was I to be pondering all this as I burned thousands of gallons of jet fuel at 30,000 feet? As the era of oil comes to an end, what have we learned? And are we about to make the same mistakes all over again? Are they simply unavoidable?
But I do know the globe has been despoiled. But it's been despoiled always in the course of developing things that make life better for people. And so then the question is, how do you reconcile the two? And the truth is, you really can't.